This is the AllPowers R1500, a versatile portable power station designed to meet a variety of needs. With over 1100 watt hours of capacity, 1800 watt inverter, and 3000 watts peak, this thing is capable of handling all kinds of tasks. It also charges impressively fast in just 45 minutes from 0 to 100%. It has four ways to charge: AC, car, solar, or AC and solar combined, which isn't really four, but it's four. And with a 15 millisecond switchover time, it functions as a UPS for your essential electronics. Its long-lasting LifePower 4 batteries allow for 3,500 cycles, and it's expandable with additional batteries. In today's video, we're gonna explore all these things and more. Let's get started. So this is really important, and I'm gonna interrupt because I was completely done with the filming and the editing of this video when a random YouTube video came across my home screen, and I watched it and saw that apparently this brand here, AllPowers, is making lots of false claims, and the batteries don't last as long as they're supposed to, and the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth aren't actually there, and it overheats. It said that the voltage isn't correct. And like basically this is complete trash, and that all of us YouTubers who are reviewing this product and saying good things about it are just doing so because we're lying and we're all in it for the money. So if you've seen that video, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And this freaked me out. I'm just like, okay, I need to go back and do a couple more tests. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep playing the video the way that I had originally intended it to be. And then I'm going to go back and I'm going to redo a couple of tests, and then we're going to determine whether or not this is a product that should be on the market, that you guys should be interested in or not. As always, you guys know that I give my honest opinions and I'm not bought or paid for. I'm going to tell you the truth. So stay tuned to the end. Let's get back to it. So let's start with the port support. When we look at the unit, all of the usable ports are on the front with exception to two, and those are gonna be on the top. It actually has two 15 watt wireless chargers up here, but the rest of the output ports are gonna be on the front. We can see right here, we've got two USB type A ports, and those are gonna be 18 watts each. And then we actually have two USB-C 100 watt ports, which is great. I love having these high power PD ports on the front. The next thing is we've got four of these 20 amp, 120 volt circuits on the front. I really like these rubber covers here. Some people might just yank them off completely, but with as dusty as things are on our homestead, especially this time of year, I like having the ports covered up a little bit. Outside of those, the only thing left to talk about here is the cigarette lighter, and that's gonna allow you to run some 12 volt appliances. Maybe you can just plug like a fridge directly into it if you've got one of those really cool 12 volt fridges. Each of these ports is turned on and off individually, or at least each of the sections. This button right here is going to turn on your pure sine wave inverter, and this button is going to turn on your DC. Now, if you want the wireless charging, you're actually going to have to turn on the DC right here, and it takes a moment or two after you've turned it on. On the left side, when you're looking at the unit, you push in down here and you get to pop up the AC in and the circuit breaker, which is down here. And then right here, we've got our solar input. On the other side, we've got our battery expansion ports. So this is where if you get the additional batteries, you can actually go in and plug them in here and you can expand the battery capacity. That is pretty much it for the ports report. It's a very basic system, but it gives you all of the ports that you're going to be looking for in a unit like this, with exception to one, that's going to be the 5521 barrel connectors that are typically down here by the cigarette lighter. The next thing is a simple thing, but I think it's fun and gives you an idea of how portable the unit is, and that's what I call, can they lift it? And we're going to go through, and I'm going to have each of my family members try to pick it up and just carry it around and see what they think.
Pretty heavy.
That's pretty heavy.
Pretty heavy, actually not bad. not too bad.
So as you can see, most of them did all right with it. It's not the heaviest, but it's definitely not the lightest unit. The handles are pretty ergonomical. It allows you to pick it up pretty good. I do prefer when there's actually like a hole that you can go all the way through with your hands. So you can grab it from the top, you can grab it from the side, you can even kind of hold it sideways. The way that's set up, if you try to do this with one hand, it's gonna slip out unless you just have like, you know, rock climber fingers or whatever. So, but overall, it's not bad. You can get it in and out of a vehicle, but you're not gonna be backpacking with it for sure. The next thing that we always do is the inverter stress test. This is where we're gonna look and see how well the inverter holds up to a high inrush, like on a table saw, a chop saw, something like that. And then also, can it hold its maximum 1800 watts continuously for any period of time? Can we exceed that for a little bit of time? And then what happens if we try to hit that 3000? We are gonna start by taking one of these plugs here, and we're going to add an 1800 watt, and come around this side, add an 1800 watt load to actually try to fill up the batteries for this main whole house system behind me. It's our 48 volt system. We're gonna go ahead and plug in here. And as soon as we do, it's gonna start slowly ramping up and feeding into these batteries. So I'm not gonna make you watch this whole thing, but I'll fast forward to the good parts. Okay, look at that. We're at 1836. So we are overdoing what it's capable of or what its stated continuous output is. That's good. We've had some inverters that haven't actually made it all the way. So we're gonna give this about a minute just to make sure everything's good. I wanna point out right down here, it's kinda hard to see, but it shows that there's 25 minutes remaining at this current output. Some of these units don't show that, and I find it super helpful. I really like it. So we're gonna use a couple of different items here, basically a space heater and a air compressor, which is already mostly full, which is gonna make it even more difficult to start. And we're gonna start off by seeing if we can just run the air compressor. So let's plug this guy in, turn it on. Thousand watts, easy peasy. Plug in the space heater. Let's put it on high. Ooh, that's putting out some heat. 1400 watts. Let's see if we can momentarily start this guy. It's gonna kill it, but let's see. Nah, it tried. Let's try to do a little bit more strategic. So let's jump to medium. All right, so now we're doing 875 watts. Yeah, it went over. So that's too much. That's too much. Oh, wait, no. The air compressor's full. All right. Let's go on medium. I think it's going to do it. Overall, it's already passed the test. 863 watts. watts. That's great. That's fantastic. Before we keep going, I want to make sure that you know that I'm going to put links in the description below, and I'm also going to include any discount codes that they pass along to me. But this so far is shaping up to be a great unit. Let's keep going. So the pros and cons. So far, what I'm seeing is pros. It has a lot of the features that you're gonna need. It has the wireless charging. That's a really nice to have feature. It has all of the ports that you're gonna want, with exception, in my opinion, to the barrel adapter, the 5521. So that is a con, unfortunately. Another thing is you've got expandable batteries as a pro. Con, it's gonna be some sort of proprietary plug, most likely. So it's gonna be a little bit harder to just hook up regular batteries to it. Pros, It's nice and lightweight, but on the con side, I kind of wish these handles were a little bit deeper, but that's really not that big of an issue. If you're carrying it with two hands, it's nice and simple. Outside of that, it performed great. It hit all of the tests that we tried to throw at it. It exceeded its 1800 watts capacity. It sustained that plus some more. It's whenever you use the USB-C, it puts out the right amount of power and it doesn't kick on the fans when you do that. So overall, I'm gonna say this is right up there with one of my favorite units. It might be one of my favorite units. I also wanna say I do trust this brand. The bigger version of this same unit is actually at my grandmother's house. I placed it there. It's working as a UPS backup, an uninterruptible power supply. So the way that that's going down is I've got the unit plugged into the wall. Then I've got her oxygen machine plugged into the unit along with a lamp. When the power goes out on the grid, the plug stops working. This never skips a beat. 15 milliseconds later, it continues to just switch over and start using batteries. And she's got about 5 hours on that unit of oxygen plus a lamp until I can get out over there or another family member can go check on her, get a generator running or something like that. So the UPS feature isn't something that should be overlooked. It's actually something that you can use instead of just putting this thing in a closet and forgetting about it until you need it. Plug your home router or your computer into it or something like that so that if the power goes out, you still have internet and a light. It's a great way to use these systems. Because if prepping has taught me anything, it's that if you don't use your preps and test them, when it's time to need them, you're not gonna be as familiar as you should be. That was the original video as it was planned, and now we're going to address the issues that were brought up by one of the other YouTubers about AllPowers lying on their website and scamming people. His first claim was that there's no Wi-Fi or Bluetooth built in, even though the website says it, and so this has made this a scam. Unfortunately, it's just a simple fact that he was pushing the wrong button. The button on the left for the USB is the correct button. You actually need to press that DC button. And if you press and hold it for 3 seconds, the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth turns on, and then you can connect to the app. His second claim was that the unit does not charge to 1500 watts, which is clearly stated on the website. Unfortunately for him, this is because this is an app setting, and because he pushed the wrong button to get into Wi-Fi, he was unable to get in and change the setting. Now that part is not clear in the documentation, and so that's unfortunate. But yes, when you change the settings, you're able to charge up to 1500 watts through AC, and that is also only during the mid stage of charging. Now, this is not something that's unique to AllPowers. This is something that is common among all battery manufacturers because you don't want to slam the very end when the battery is all but fully charged with 1500 watts. And you also don't want to do it when the battery is just starting off. It's that mid stage where you can actually charge really quickly. However, the quicker you charge, the more damage you do to your battery. So by default, 1000 watts is the limit. His next claim was that the units do not output 120 volts. I don't know what to say other than mine do. So I get 120 volts, you can see right here, 120 volts on the output, and everything seems to work just fine. His fourth claim is that AllPowers just slaps together poor product components and all they're trying to do is make a quick buck. I don't see any proof of this. In fact, I see AllPowers continuously trying to improve their brand and make sure that they are putting out quality products. They're not in the business of wrecking their company just so they can make a quick buck and get out of here. His next claim is that the units overheat every single time, and I don't know what to say here other than I did all the exact same tests that he did. And mine worked just fine. I had no overheating issues. I was able to run the unit at max 100% output all the way from 100% down to where it shut down at 5% to make sure that it had enough battery life to maintain the settings and all the things that it needs. And that's very common. You don't want to run it to zero. So mine passed this test with flying colors. I don't know what to say other than maybe he got a bad unit. Then his next claim was that the units are only 60% efficient. Well, at 100% output, I got 80% efficiency, which is actually not really that bad for running at 100%. The higher you get to 100%, the lower the efficiency. And so this performed exactly the way that I would have expected it to. In fact, it did fairly well. Okay, so that's it. The tests are done. I went back and checked all the things that were complained about in this previous YouTuber's video. And I've got to say, he was pushing the wrong button, so he didn't get into the Wi-Fi. Because he wasn't in the Wi-Fi or the Bluetooth, he wasn't able to change the setting to where it could charge at the higher voltage, or rather at the higher wattage. The voltage thing, I don't really know why. Mine's at 120 volts. His was at 107, 108, something like that. I can't figure out why that would be the case on his. I ran mine from 100% all the way down to zero, actually to 5, because it stops at 5% to make sure that it doesn't completely die. And it didn't overheat, and it had 80% efficiency, and passed all the tests. I mean, it did a really great job. I don't know what to say other than maybe he got a lemon. Mine did great, and I don't know. Like I said, my grandmother has got hers. It's been going for 6 months, 24/7 in UPS, and has tripped on to run her oxygen many times through power outages. I don't know. So do what you will. If you want to spend more money for an Anker or a Blue Eddy or something like that, go for it. They have lemons sometimes too. So it's not like, you know, every brand gets it right every time. So I don't know what to tell you other than mine is great and I love it. So hopefully this video has been helpful. I'm Eric with East Texas Homestead, encouraging you to live faithfully and prepare thoroughly for good times or for bad. I'll see you on this video right here.